Normandy. My name's Captain Duff, and I am playing Skyrim, but today I am not playing Skyrim, obviously playing Skyrim, but I just wanted to do a quick, I've got 90 minutes to spend. I don't have a lot of time today to focus on full stream on top of the one I already did this morning. I just wanted really to get spend some time where I can catch up on some of the crafting that I've not been doing. So I've got a bunch of alchemy that I can be doing, I've got a bunch of chanting that I could be doing, I've got a bunch of smithing that I could be working on. So 90 minutes, that is a great opportunity to spend some time on that kind of thing. So I'm in the Bard's College in Solitude, but where I was just before that was in Skyrim. Wait, hang on. Whiterun. Where did I go? Oh, that's right. I went back to that place and those dudes, the Imperial, said, well, that stuff's gone anyway. Okay, so let me bamf. I'm gonna Scooby-Doo time travel this shit up. And we're gonna go back to Whiterun. And by back to Whiterun, I mean back to Whiterun. And oh, that's what it does. So it lets you learn all of the things fast. Oh, that's pretty cool. Alright, so we're gonna go carrying. Okay. So we're gonna go inside and we're going to do some alchemy. Now I have an alchemy ring here, and I have an alchemy hat, and some alchemy gauntlets, some steel plate alchemy gauntlets. Which means we currently have 12, 17, 20. 12 and 17 and 20 is 49. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna grab everything. So gross! Oh, that was so gross! Can't believe how gross that was! Alright, and we have some recipes in here. So this one. There's no point grabbing the Atronux Forge recipe as we are not at the Atronux. Alright, now, let's see what we've got. Books. Cure Disease. Charred Skeever Hide and Mud Crab Chitin. Let's do that one. Charred Skeever Hide and Mud Crab. Skeever Hide and Mud Crab Chitin. Got a lot of that. Alright. Oh, we know it's going to restore stamina. Really? Yes, Phil. Tail and Givertail and Void Salt. What's the next word? Cure Disease Potion. Shard Skeever Hide and Mud Crab. But that's not what it said it would do. Shard Skeever Hide and Mud Crab Chitin. It says restore stamina. Oh shit, there we go. They both also resist poison and they both also cure disease. So what did we make? Potion of resist poison cures all diseases, restores stamina and resists poison. They make a second one of those, hey? Is there anything else that we have that resists poison or restores stamina or cures disease? Orc feathers. Orc feathers do. All we know they do is cure disease. So we might as well. Wait, hang on. Where is save that for now. Is that all it's gonna do? Only got one charred skeever hide. Because I mean, I've not been skinning my charred skeevers. Please selection. Is there anything that we don't know what it does yet? Oh, look at all that fortify barter. Any more? Yeah, there's more. One Abyssinian long fin. A bunch of lungs. Don't do anything else though, that's the problem. All I know is weakness to fire. Right. Let's go back to the get over there. My books. I don't need that one anymore. Damage, health, poison. Givertail and Void Salt. Not happening. I'm not wasting Void Salt on that. Fear poison. Added Mammoth Tusk and a Daedra Heart. Really? A Daedra Heart? I have padded Mammoth Tusk. Okay. Furs. Daedra Heart. I've got 8 of them. And added Mammoth Tusk. I've got exactly 1. Craft it. Was it even the first thing of the Daedra Heart? It was not. Oh, I see. All right, what else? What else have we got? Paralysis poison, anise root, and swamp fungal pod. I'm pretty sure we've already and resist poison, thistle and falma ear. Probably have a few falma ears. Oh, yeah, there's the paralysis. Elves, yeah, Falmania. And Thistle? It was Thistle, wasn't it? go. Resist poison. Damage, health, resist poison. Huh. Yeah. Not real keen on just taste testing these components when they when they're worth a lot of money. Alright, so I guess I could be stop. I should be using up stuff I have a lot of, which is blue mountain flowers. The things that are grayed out are the things that I've already tried to combine it with and we've discovered does nothing. A lot of nightshade. I have a lot of purple. This little we know it doesn't work with. Now I could consult my fellow word I'm looking for. I could consult my fellow alchemist and ask around, hey, do you know what goes with blue mountain flowers? Got more purple than blue. Hey, do you know what goes well with purple mountain flowers? But it's a high chance of me just wasting stuff. One thing of there's two things of purple mountain flower I haven't, two properties I haven't even unlocked. So I've got a fair amount of bleeding ground. Let's try this. Unfortunately, every time it's unsuccessful, it deselects everything. So I've got to go scroll all the way back down to purple. What's in it though? Restore stamina and resist frost. Alright. So if I can't find anything with it. Oh, so that's both. They're both restore stamina. I don't know anything about that. That's both restore stamina. Damage magicka. Probably not gonna. Stamina, weakness to magic. The other thing in it? Resist frost. So yeah, it's gonna make things with snowberries all day long. Got more snowberries than anything. Resist frost, yep. Theoretically, resist frost, resist poison, ravage stamina. I want the last one. Oh wait, I definitely don't want to waste the vampire. Void slots on it. I do have one void slot. The thing that needed void salts. This one? No, this one. Void Salt and Skeever Tail. The question is, what else am I going to use Void Salt? Well, there is this. Fire Salt, Greater Soul Gem, Broom, Brundum. So, there's very likely a Void Salt option for that. But the chances of me actually going and doing that, pretty low. Especially by its friend. Actually. Okay, so Bleeding Crown and Powdered Antlers. or lavender? Okay. So Bleeding Crown and lavender. Hooray! Resist magic. Alright, and powdered antlers. I don't have powdered antlers. I have small antlers and large antlers. I don't have very many large antlers. I have more small antlers. No, I have less small antlers. Oh no, it mentioned something about a weakness to poison. Alright, let me try that one. There we go. Alright, cool. Yay, we're learning things. Alright, what else does this book have to teach? Alright. Death Bell. Oh shit, it would be remiss to overlook that the blooms of the Death Bell are very effective in mixtures for boosting one's alchemy skill. They just add Death Bell as the optional component and boom, alchemy explosion. Oh, alright, well that is good to know. Dragonflies. Orange and blue are fully different breeds or color variations. Orange dragonfly, when combined with the very hardy barnacles found on the coast, transfer some of their flighty nature, giving the herbalists some very nimble fingers. Okay, I can do that. Orange darter and barnacles. Okay. What are the Nordic barnacles and MNO orange right next to each other? Fortified pickpocket. Now, what happens if we put Death Bell in here? Went up a bit. Doesn't seem to have made any difference. Let me check my inventory and see if the potions are the same. They sure are. 1, 2, 3. Resist poison. Resist poison, but also restore stamina and cure disease. Level 7? Oh, see, that's a disappointment. But my alchemy skill is not that great. What is it, 30? It was just there, wasn't it? Alright. Use in poisons. Oh wait, you don't just add it to anything. It's a plus alchemy potion. Okay. So what is the other thing that goes in there? It's fortify alchemy potion. Okay. Egg Raven Claw. Best obtained in shops. Inadvisable to suggest one collect themselves. Hmm. mixed with snow runes. Found myself capable of comprehending enchantments I had believed mystifying after ingesting the mixture. So, Hagraven Claw and Snowberry. Hagraven Claw, I only have one. And Snowberry, I have lots of. Gonna be like Fortify Illusion or something like that. Fortify Enchanting. Right, well, that's gonna help in half an hour. Too bad I only have one of the claws. Right, was the next one Juniper Berries? Jazbay! Made is combined with simple garlic to enhance the regeneration of Magicka. While no longer against law, picking these grapes in large amounts is best kept to oneself. Alright, so regen Magicka. Cool. Jazbay and garlic. Garlic, Jazbay, I have lots of these. Regenerate Magicka. 34% faster for 300 seconds. Yeah, we might. Craft a bunch of those. Okay. Oh, there it is. Right past it. Regenerate Magicka. Now it's 35%. Cool. That was a good find. Remind me to pick more Jazbay grapes. The other thing I need to combine Death Bell for Fortified Alchemist. As for the Dragonflies, Luna Moth, Crushed and Distilled. It was difficult to perform at first, and then I resolved to discover all its experimental for these creatures are simply that beautiful. They can be used for creating poisons that damage Magicka. But they work in potions of invisibility. I feel like I should be taking notes. Okay, so Luna Moth. Plus giant question marks equals invisibility. What was the other one? Death Bell plus question marks equals fortify. Alchemy. Okay, what else do we have? Tundra Cotton. Oh, staple potions of fortifying magicka, but resisting spells as well. I think we already know that about Tundra Cotton. And Nightshade. Exceedingly effective as a pure poison, combined with other compounds to stiffen joints. Paralysis. And that is the end of the book. So, under problem. All the way down the bottom. Oh, I can't sort in reverse on the name, that's a shame. Nightshade, damage to health, damage to magic regent. So there's a paralysis thing here as well. We go across here. Through paralysis. Got canis root. So that should make a paralysis. Oh wow, it did not. Stiffen joints. What else is it going to mean? Well, I am very confused. That's a bit of a shame. I mean, I've got lots of nightshade to play around with, but, you know, still. Be doing a lot of food cooking, but I don't really need to. What am I looking for? The Tundra Cotton. Yeah, Fortify Magicka. Yeah, we already know that. And Fortify Vada. There are some things here that we just don't know about yet. And some of these things we got by accident. Accidentally trying stuff out. Is, hey? I mean, I doubt it. That might maybe. Right, let's see what we've got that would help. There's going to be a don't say. Okay. Probably have some of those. Oh. 28 seconds. That's not too bad. Don't want to waste. Well, I don't know what Nurnroot will do. If I add a third one, does it make the invisibility better, or am I just wasting it? I think if it's three things that all match one thing, I'm just wasting it. A lot of that, either. part of the dirt. Still 28 seconds. Well. Restores magicka. Really? I must have eaten. Pepper. 40% weaker to magic for 30 seconds, but it restores 35 points of magic. That's crazy. Right. Giant's Toe. Increases carrying capacity by 28%, but also no stamina regeneration for 35 seconds. Which is actually great for me. We literally are. And fortify carry away. I have some. Again, it's weak to magic, but it restores magicka. Yeah, everything. Okay. Where are we? Bear claw. Do we have hanging moss? I am absolutely 100% consulting my holy damage, magicka regen, fortify one-handed, and fortify health. Oh wow! 552 septums. No magicka regen for 35 seconds, but one-handed weapons do 28% more damage for a minute. And your health is increased. Nobody really cares about the health increase. Oh, that one's huge. Do I have a small pearl? I have a pearl. I don't have any small pearl. While I'm down here at Small Ant, grab one of those and this long fin. Restoration spells are 28% longer, 28% stronger, but weakness to magic on top of that. The death though. Oh, okay. Nori mentioned at all about fortify. We know not glowing mushroom. Ruler Betty. 50% speed and it damages their health. Last of the small antlers. A weakness to poison and it damages their health. Sort of stands out. Bees and honeycomb. It restores stamina, but it also restores 35 points of stamina, but a concentrated poison temporarily reduces the maximum and current stamina by 14 points for 10 seconds. So it restores 35 points of stamina and then it takes 14 of that away. That sounds ridiculous. Why? Why would it do that? Why on earth would it do that? What else can I combine it with? Playalata. Regenerate stamina, 35% faster. And see, what do I have there? Hag Raven Feathers. Oh. Maybe not. I have one beehive husk. Oh no, it's dropping out. My Twitch connection's dropping frames, which usually means that it's it's all going to crap. And it usually means I need to either kill the stream and restart it, or it will eventually fix itself. I never know if I have any. Oh, I have one. Fortify sneak, fortify light armor. That's huge. Alright, what else do we have in here? Bleeding crown. Did we do bleeding crown already? Yeah, I'm still dropping frames like nothing. with Tundra Cotton, right? By block. Thirty-five alchemy. Blisterwort. Now we know blisterwort and wheat go together. We were told that by one of the farmers. Apparently, also rock warbler. It restores health while damaging your stamina. Although it looks like it damages your stamina and then restores your health. Which means if you have removes all of the beneficial effects from poisons, this would just be a poison. It wouldn't also restore health. Excuse me. If I don't care about stamina, I can take that myself. Yeah. Bluefly, butterfly wings. Blue mountain flower, fortify conjuration. It says. Also, damages magical regen. Bone meal. Conjuration and damage stamina. Choice hunter antenna, which we have two of. Fortify enchanting. Oh shit. So this damages. We just learned all four of the Chorus Hunter antenna. They have all four of them in common. Fortify conjuration, fortify enchanting. Damage stamina, damage magical regen. Oh shit. The Chorus Hunter antenna is basically a blue butterfly wing if you can't find blue butterflies. Okay, let's. Spider eggs and spriggan sap. That go really well with. Spider eggs. Or spriggan sap. Just. No, not just for. Yeah, I'm still dropping frames. I did not meant to press R, I meant to press F. That's fine. Fine. Okay. Blue dart wing. I don't like that. I approach that from the other side. Bugger. Fortifies health. While making you run away, and a swamp fungal pod. Resist shock and resist and restore health. Oh, nice. Now that's handy. Still dropping frames. Not my CPU. It's the connection to the trip server. Fine. Right, where was up to? Oh hey, Blue Mountain Flower. I'm pretty sure that we, Hanging Moss? Well, we know all of those things. And wheat. Restore health, but also increases health and restores health. Now that's sort of what we want. Let's make a bunch of those. I can make loads of items. I need to... Okay. Work backwards a little bit from here. Okay, that should teach us something. There we go. Lingering damage magicka. Drains 70 magicka. Okay. Learn everything from wheat? No. Oh, that's gonna bug me. A giant's toe. I think a giant's toe or a Daedra heart is going to be more useful or less useful. Do both, I guess. Boom! The potion to fortify health. Except you don't get any stamina for 35 seconds. Alright. Now, what was it? Wheat and blue flowers. And we can just make a shitload of these. Until I run out of wheat. Alright, I've stopped dropping frames in OBS. 9,591 frames I dropped. So I wouldn't be surprised to find out that the stream has been cut into two parts. But it's only a crafting catch-up, so I'm not really too worried about it. Alchemy. I mean, I guess I could keep some weight. I mean, restoring 36 points of health, I'm not actually going to be using them. I mean, they're pretty cool, but at this level of alchemy, I need them to be a lot more potent. Alright, let's see what else we can find. Okay, do I have any boar tusks? I don't think I do. I do not, so bone meal is next. Bone meal and two butterfly wing we've probably already done. Fortify conjuration and damage stamina, yep. Yeah. I think we can learn anything from that. A briar heart. Did I accidentally eat one? Oh, there we go. Tundra cotton. There we go. Fortify block, fortify magicka. Or you're blocking wizards everywhere. It is That's fine. Butterfly. Bring me up to B. For a second, visibility. Butterfly wings, restore health, fortify barter. Either Daedra heart. Saber card. Or, you know, both. $350 though. Problem right there. Canis root. Oh, canis root. Spider egg or a rock warbler? Damage stamina, but fortify one handed. Fortify marks. Shit. Could fortify marksman and one handed at the same time? It's only for a minute. But. I'm still. Charred ski behind. Well, I might want to hang on to that for cure disease, just in case. Cure disease, resist poison, restore stamina. Pretty cool. What else does it do? Oh, really? It restores health? Card ski behind and I have a saving card and mud crab chicken. It also restores 36 points of health. Now we're out. So there we go. That worked. Churros egg. An invisibility potion. Not what I call them. What else does it do though? Oh, of course, if I combine it with lunar moth wings. Also damages his magicka. I don't want it to damage magicka. But it's going to. 28 seconds though. What else does it do? Death bells and bleeding crown. Let's help. Bleeding. Bells and. go. Learn all the things. Alright, learn all that already. Chicken eggs! It's been 55 minutes already. I'm not even gonna get the rest of the crafting done. Chicken eggs, and you'll never guess. Nightshade. Chicken eggs and nightshade. Decrease no magicka regeneration for 36 seconds and loss of 7 stamina. That's actually nasty. How many chicken eggs do I have? It's really expensive. Look how much it's worth. It's worth a lot. Amusingly, there's no such thing as fortify alchemy. There's enchanting and everything you can think of, but not alchemy. There's enchanting and smithing and barter, but nothing for fortify alchemy, which is pretty cool. Alright, what's... creep cluster, we know everything about. Cyrodiilic spade tails. Look. There's some things I've never found, so that's nothing to double up with. Just go okay, salt pile. Fortify restoration, but ravage health. Where were we? And we're missing. Blue Darwin. Oh, I'm missing one of the things from Blue Darwin. I'm missing from Blue Darkwing. Orange Darkwing. Oh, we know that one already. Slaughterfish egg. Slaughterfish egg. What else does slaughterfish egg combine with? Garlic. Boom. Look at that selection. Garlic. Man, I'm looking one of the ones for bone meal as well. I'll get back to it. Dragon's tongue. Alright, what have we got? Fly, Amantina will give us that one. And I know that one already. Scaly Volatolia or Taproot. 12, 5. Scaly Volatolia it is. Regen stamp, fortify two-handed, fortify illusion. 581 septums. That is a very expensive potion. Check that shit out. I was still worried about actually making gold. 29% stronger illusion seconds, 29% better two-handed. 7 regents, 36% faster for 5 minutes, and it resists 21% of fire damage. That is an amazing potion. That one can go on the shelf. Thanks, Dragon Tongue. And it makes fortified barter. Dwarven Oil. I'm just going to use some Dwarven Oil there as well. That's okay. Oh wow. Fire Salts. Salt Pile. Taproot. I have all four things in common. Target is 14% weaker to magic though. But it regenerates faster, you gain 36 points of it, and your illusion spells are better. That Taproot and Dwarven Oil both all filled in. Ectoplasm. What do we know about Ectoplasm? It restores magicka. What do we know? Let's try Red Mountain Flower. And Nightshade. Red Mountain Flower. And excellent things to be combining it with. Fortify Destruction, Fortify Magicka. Fortifies Magicka, restores Magicka, and yeah, take a bit of a hit, but holy shit, is that potion going to be worth it? That's a potion I might actually consider carrying around. Maybe. A little bit. With the alchemy thing, I can remove the health damaging section from it. With the points in alchemy. Now, speaking of points in alchemy, what I probably should have been doing is, let's level up. I'm going to choose Magicka. And Magicka again. Oh, I'm an expert. And yeah, I'm going to choose Magicka again. Alchemy. Three things to spend points for, but 20% stronger. And then if they restore health, Magicka, or stamina, it's 25% more powerful. And then here, potions you mix with beneficial effects have an additional 25% greater magnitude. Eating an ingredient reveals two effects instead of one first effect. That's the one. Oh, 100% alchemy. Oh, 100 in alchemy. All negative effects are removed from created poisons, and all positive effects are removed from created from created potions, and all positive effects are removed from created. Uh, Poisons applied to weapons. Oh, is that how you use poisons? You don't throw them, you coat them on your weapons. What am I gonna do with it then? Nothing. That's why I've been selling all of my poisons. Two ingredients are gathered from harvestable ingredient sources. Oh shit, that is nice. Oh wow, double ingredients? What am I going to do with that? I mean, requires 70 alchemy, but wow. I could put all three of my perks into alchemy. They're 20% stronger. And if they restore health, magic, or stamina, they're 25% more powerful. Does that make everything in there 25% more powerful, or just the health, magic, or stamina restoration? That one that I just did, that restores health, as well as fortifying destruction and magicka regen. Sorry, restored magicka. Does that 25% bonus count for everything? Or just the regen? I don't know. But do I... Yeah, I've got points in conversion. I might need by apprentice alliteration. Maybe. Sorry, alteration. Not alliteration. Alteration. My heavy armor. Anything going? It could be better. Do I get anything for 50? I don't think I do. That's 60. Wanted. Still not what I wanted. Gale and plate is 50. 30. Orcish is 50. Daedric is 90. Magical stuff is 60. My heavy armor is 34. That's hilarious. My light is 31. I've pickpocketed one time. That's how much I've actually got from pickpocketing. Just that little bit there. Do you want to put points in? That one. But, you know. I guess I don't really need to. Oh, I can nearly afford haggling. But where I should be putting in those points is in conjuration and restoration. Sorry, destruction and restoration. So that's for swords. Ooh. Oh, that's handy. Wow. Conjure Schmuck's 50% more powerful, but I need 80. 80 for it. They last twice as long. I've got that. Yeah, three times. I need 80 conjuration. Right, destruction though. Close to that. Don't have anything in here though, I'd need one for that. And then I need to actually start using frost spells. I haven't been, I've just been firebolting. And I could rank that up some more so it does more damage. A little worried about Where are these spells? When do I get access to those? And then restoration. Right. Okay. Huh? I'd really like a second point there, but that's a long way off. That's an entire level by itself. Happening for a while. I don't know. Maybe I don't need a lot of points in alteration. Alteration gives me oak, stone flesh, and telekinesis. Which one's which? Iron candlelight. Oh, and equilibrium. Novice, apprentice. Oh, telekinesis is an adept spell. To telekinesis costs so much for me to cast. It's an adept spell. Yeah, I'm nowhere near 50 alteration yet. Mage armor. 3-4 times as strong if you're not actually wearing armor, which I am. I'm wearing light armor. But I could be wearing robes of destruction rather than the vampire armor of destruction that I have. Oh shit, really? Oh wow. I'm not quite at the level to afford to be able to unlock that yet anyway. Yeah, and I haven't started on enchantment. This is where the soul trap part is. Soul gems provide extra magic for recharging. Death blows to creatures, but not people trapped. 5% of the victim's soul recharging the weapon. I can put 2 enchantments on the same item. Shock, frost, fire. Oh wow, that's a huge progression. Actually, destruction is the same. 60. Oh, there's 60 all the way. But this one here is 50, and then frost, 60, and then shock, 70. So, yeah, fire is certainly here's your basic level magic killing thing stuff, and then frost, and then shock. I wouldn't mind 20% easier. Item weight and value reduce the pickpocketing odds. 25% easier when they're asleep. Oh shit. I have a new mission. I have a brand new mission in life. We are going to go pickpocketing so much. I need one more rank. We are going to go pickpocketing so much. Carrying capacity increased by 100? Yes, absolutely. That is such a draw card for me. I can't believe I didn't notice that or forgot about it or nobody told me. What the hell? Yeah, alchemy. I should put some points out. Oh, really? The next one's just, well, then that unlocks this one. What do I want to get to? Well, I don't think it really matters. That one. That's what I want to get to. But it's off here, which is, I don't care about poison. I'm not using them. Why is this off poison? That sucks. Why is this off poison? That's two completely wasted perks for me. I am really annoyed. Get 70 alchemy before I can get it anyway, but why is that a thing? Why would you just notice something? Okay, experiment at 0 of 3, so that's if you put everything into there it reveals all 4 of them. That's pretty good. Am I using any illusion spells? I don't think I am. Clairvoyance, Fury, and Muffle. I haven't used any of them at all. I have been using Oak Flesh though. Okay. I haven't animated the undead yet. 80. Oh. That would be cool. It would mean actually hitting things with my swords though, which is the thing that I'm not really up to doing yet. Might get to that later. I don't have restoration jewel casting. Do I need it? No, I wanted to get some enchanting done today, but I've spent the entire stream doing alchemy and messing around in the level up menu. Let's put a point into it. Feeling I'm gonna want to put one of those up very soon. I don't want the one where they run away. I don't want them running away. I want them staying where I can kill them and then loot them. All right. Where was that to? Dwarven oil, ectoplasm, elves ear. Alright, oh, fire salts. Really? And Whitecap. I've got 16 of them. Those anyway. That's the other thing it does. Canis root. Of course, Elves Ear fortifies marksmen. Why wouldn't it fortify marksmanship? Alright. I have a saber cut. Restore stamina, restore health, damage magicka. Silver side perch, beaver tail. Got one silver side perch. Well, I've got a silver side perch here. Alright, restore stamina. Oh, interesting. So, a beaver tail and a purple mountain tail. Oh, it's gonna be an absolute mess, that potion, but oh well. Almahir. A human heart and or troll fat. I have a human heart. I know nothing about it. Okay, let's. And hanging rod. Yay! Alright. Okay, back to Falmania. Poison. Spider egg? Spider egg. Fortify lock picking. 17% easier. Nice. 37? Only worth 37 septums. Cheap at half of the price, which is a thing I don't really understand. Okay, what else don't I know about fire salt? Weakness to frost, resist fire, resist magicka, restore magicka, regenerate magicka. Okay, let's see. Moon sugar, lemon row, jazz bacon. Put dwarven oil, we know. Yep, okay. Garlic, regen magicka, yep. Jazz bay grapes. I used up all of the jazz bay grapes. Fine. Salt pile. We don't know regenerate magicka. Alright, clear that selection before I use all of my fire bolts. Garlic, we're still missing something in. Got 5 minutes left. What don't we know? Poison. Regenerate health. Juniper berries. Lunar mothwing. Visible. Nordic. Barnacles. What if I pick one? Chicken's egg. There we go. Water breathing. You can get water breathing from a chicken's egg. Very new. Our magic number is 43 right now. Clear selections. There we go. That was the last thing we're missing on chicken's egg. Excellent. Missing one thing on Daedra Heart. I'm a bit worried to find out what that is. Frost Miriam. Oh, fly Aminator. Get ahead of ourselves. Okay, what are we missing? Resist fire. No, we're missing frenzy. Blister Wart. Human heart, what about fire? We've got a fair amount of blister warp though. Oh, and we didn't know that about blister warp. What else am I missing about blister warp? What was the whole point? Go through and learn all the things. Damage seminar, restore health. Fortify smithing. Glowing mushroom. Holy shit. ...34% better weapon and armory improving. Yeah! Cool! Oh, that's very handy. Wait, thanks Blister Wart. Be wasting you on health potions. Where was up to? Frost Mirror? My stolen frost mirror. Miriam. Alright, it's 4 o'clock, which means Juniper Paws is likely to come on any minute now. Purple Mountain Flower. Oh yeah, okay, cool. And Silverside Perch. Okay. I do not have. Okay. What do I know? Resist frost. That's it. Okay, so. Lavender? Grass pod? Grass pod. Fortify snake and resist frost and get your magicka poisoned. Sucks to be you. The other thing. Creep cluster. already know that one. Oh, wait. Large antlers. Large antlers. What else can we combine large antlers with? So we're not wasting out the large antlers. A torch bug thorax. Got shitloads of those. There we go. Fortify stamina and damage stamina regen. Thanks. Thanks, large antlers. Why wouldn't you do that? Okay. So that's all of just use the stolen ones first for crying out loud. Okay. Frost salts is the last one in F. I got 5 of them, so there we go. Alright. Yeah, okay. Probably not gonna work out real well. Hair growing feathers? I could really use some moon sugar, but yeah, I don't have any moon sugar. I'm gonna leave that one for now until I get some moon sugar. Moon sugar is expensive, yo. But frost salts and moon sugar, oh, look out. Okay, garlic is finished. Giant lichen. I only have 2 of these damn things. Oh, and they don't share anything. Ugh. Yeah. They have one cool thing and everything else sucks. Oh, with pearl, you don't say. Something there. See if I can learn things about pearls. Here's the thing, not that one, not Briarheart. Mako? Pine thrush name? What do I know about honeycomb? Not gonna tell me, is it? I have some pine thrush eggs. Pine thrush egg. Oh, look at that list of shit we learned! Pine thrush egg did give us a second one for giant lichen, thank goodness. Awesome. Clear the hell out of that selection. Oh, I do have juniper berries. Oh, it's jazzbay grapes I don't have. So we learnt 2 things out of giant lichen. What are the other 2? Okay, the one we needed jazzbay grapes for. Skeever tail. And bee or hagraven feathers. Hagraven feathers. Okay, that's a new thing. Cool. And either Beaver tail or an eye of a saber cat, maybe. So probably a skeever tail just because I have lots of. I have trauma root, don't I? Alright, let's make that one. gonna have a lot of opportunity. I'm keeping an eye out for JP. He'll be here relatively soon. He said she'd be on at 4. When she gets here, I'm gonna jump off. Blow dust. Okay. What do we know so far? Damage Magicka. So. Ooh. Glowing Mushroom. And Nightshade. It damages your Magicka regen, but Destruction spells are 43% stronger for a minute, and you resist 26%. Of shock damage for 60 seconds. So there's 17 seconds after you don't get any magic back that you, well, if you're casting that whole time anyway, you're not getting any magic back while you're casting. So if you pop it at the start of combat and front load that destruction damage, and then you'll have 17 seconds of Magicka regen, during which you're still resisting shock and not really the best. Holy shit, is that worth a lot of money though? No. Oh, I wanted to not cast the other one, that was all. Where am I up to? Okay, glowing mushrooms. Grass pods. Okay, resist Savage Magicka, so Friggin Sap or River Betty. Any River Betty's left? I have two, and it doesn't know it. Friggin Sap know it? It did not. I'm not throwing both of them in there, it's cool. And what was the other thing? Can't remember. Fine. Poison, Ravage Magicka, Gore Magicka. White Cat. Yes. Oh, or Pearl. Let me guess White Cat. Oh, there we go. Fortify Alteration. They last 35% longer for 60 seconds. What? How does that work? It restores 43 points of magicka, but reduces your maximum current magicka by 17 points for 10 seconds. Not too bad. Reload selection. So we're up to H. Bag Raven Feathers. So we only had the one claw. Making sure JP hasn't snuck in without me. Magicka, weakness to shock, frenzy, and fortify control. So, troll fat or fly eminent, or we've gone past one. Probably troll fat. And let's lavender maybe. Alright, troll fat and lavender. What did I do? Oh, I pressed D. I didn't want to do that. Hanging moss, we know everything. Hawk feathers, we still have one thing left to uncover. Is it fortify light armor? No. Is it fortify one-handed? It's fortify one-handed. Hanging moss? Honeycomb? Honeycomb! Let me go down a rock warble egg. Oh, that one? Okay. Honeycomb. Oh, what's the other thing we don't know about honeycomb? And knock both of these off at the same go. Wait. No, I don't want honeycomb. That's light armor. I'm gonna do one handed. Oops. I was looking at the wrong thing. Hawk feathers do both, that's why. So anise root. Oh, my rock wall though. Yeah, I already know that. I mean, anise root will already have everything full. I go to rock wall egg, I'm missing one of those things. Weakness to me. Laser focus. That's not that one. Ah, there we go. Learning many new things. Alright. Honeycomb. Wildly annoying. There's a lot of stuff between there that I don't have yet. Bees and pearls. Restore stamina, ravage stamina. Oh, well. Really? Do I have any pearls left? I do. Well, that's the one thing I'm missing from pearl goes in there. And a skeever tail? And a skeever tail. Learning many things. Skeever tail, fortified light armor. Who knew? Ice wraith teeth. Skipping over the human bits because I don't have them. Alright, weakness to frost, invisibility. We want. Heavy armor and juniper berries and white cap, I guess. Now we already know weakness to fire from that one. That's fine. We're not going to learn anything else about. This would go great with frost salts and moon sugar, but oh well. Fine, it's fine. Old bleeding crown, actually, if I haven't. If I've accidentally skipped over that one. Alright, juniper berries. And white cap. Alright. Few things missing from the ice wraith teeth. Imp stool is up next. And Juniper Paws has gone live. Excellent. So do imp stool real quick. So that I remember where I'm up to. Of course, I don't have human flesh with me, but I do have swamp fungal cogs. And imp stools, slaughterfish eggs. Slaughterfish egg, yes, excellent. The last thing missing from slaughterfish egg as well. Alright, that is great. Alright, we've learnt all of the things down to I. So we can pick this up with J next time. It won't be tomorrow morning. I don't know when it will be. It won't be later tonight. I've got role playing tonight. And that's liable to go a very long time. I'll put all the ingredients back. Okay, right. 500. And then I will kick this stream over to JT's channel. I nearly ate a Daedra heart. Because I'm just going R-A-R-A-R-A. And it wasn't above 5. I'm nearly out of tap right now, so. Wow. That was bracing. Still at 134 potions. Oh wow, all of these poisons. Oh shit. Look at this. Look at. Look at this. This potion of fortify health. 790 septums. I don't really need them, though. This poison. That's that huge one that I just made. Oh. Yeah, all these poisons, it's like, you know, coat your weapon and then stab them, and then that's how you apply it. Or, you know, drink it yourself for its beneficial side effects. But how do I get that fortify destruction without getting the magicka decoy? I guess it depends, I guess it's in the way that you use it. It's in the way that you use it. So I'll put 8:30, the potion shop is still open. So what I'm gonna do is duck up to the potion shop and sell these potions. And I've got to remember to put the potion things back. And then I've got to cut myself off to
Got something for just about everybody in here. Give a holler if you have any questions.
Oh, don't mind me coming behind the counter, because you're all the way back
so
there.
So you're an alchemist then?
Yeah, a little bit. Okay, potions. You've got 500 gold. Can you even afford this? You can afford to buy two things. Now, what I should be doing, no, I should be selling the really expensive stuff, because that's how you get better, creatures and people up to level 9 will attack anything nearby. Well, that is all damage. Alright, I'm gonna sell that one. We got 195 gold left. So that one's 196. 191. Decreases. Conjuration spells last stamina is no stamina regen, but you get better stamina and it gives you stamina back. This is the most useless poison ever. Seriously, this is a ridiculous... Who invented this combination? Seriously. Who came up? Who planned this? Alright, have I got anything in here that's worth 15 gold? Really? That was what I came up with? 7% item, 7% enchanting. Well, I don't want that. Yeah, fine, you can keep your 11 gold. Fine. I've got that, I've got that. I know how to do those. And you have a hair grabbing claw. You have a hist carp. Oh, you've got a jazz bait grape. Oh, and a beehive husk. And the other one of those. Oh, I'm missing a thing from bone meal. And a briar heart. 204 gold. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna that and that and I don't care about stamina. I'd like to know what the last one is though. And they're only worth 4 gold each. No, I'm just gonna buy everything you have. Alright. How much gold do you have now? 511. Okay, you can... Two-handed weapons, illusion spells, resist fire. That is the best potion ever. Why is it only worth 276 septims? That's all poison, you can have that. 221. 224. That's 210. Oh, then I gotta do something for 11. You can have that one. Thank you.
Come back anytime if you need a remedy.
I will. Thank you. And the other place we can sell stuff is the Drunken Huntsman. Nope. Hell, it wasn't the Drunken Huntsman because it wanted me to pick the lock. I'm like, nope, that's not it.
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for. Hello, Fred. Bows and arrows for the mighty huntsman.
Excellent. That's fantastic. We don't want to buy my potions. That's...
Thank you very much for your business.
Bellafor, maybe? Bellafor might buy them. Alright, my mistake. Well, I guess that's it then. Cool. put everything back in the chest. Fine. I mean, I could try selling them in solitude. I sort of prefer everything to be in the same place, where I know where it is. Potions. There's a lot of stuff that I can. 54 potions of fortify health. But they're sort of a little bit pointless. Increases light armor. Okay, so 28% harder to detect. Cool. Increases light armor. Pretty good. 34% harder to detect and resist frost damage, but also take magicka damage. Well, that's less useful. Yeah, see, that one's less useful than those two. Regenerate health, can breathe underwater. See? Hard to know where to categorize that one. 43% regenerate magicka. 34. 35. Why are these two? Oh, there we go. 36 and illusion spells. And weaker to magic, and oh wow, that's got everything. Stamina region, potion of resist poison, and a bunch of other crap. Alright, let me look in the chest. This is gonna be tough. What I'm looking for is potion of oh, 150, eh? All these fortify block potions, they can all get sold very easily. Increases light armor score by 17 points. Crazy. Carrying capacity plus 28, but no stamina regen. But 14% weaker to magic. That's not too bad. That's excellent. Resists 4% of all magic. Damages the stamina of both. Yeah, I care about that. That's just straight conjuration better. Yeah, see, that's fantastic. That's an excellent thing. And this is very disappointing. What, 7% stronger? Only 7% stronger for 30 seconds? Come on. That's two things. Oh, they're terrible. See, that's what I want. I'll just take two of those. Oh, well, yeah, just as sort of a backup. Oh, well, no, wait, that's a silly idea. I should take the plentiful one. Extreme one, especially because it's stolen. I nearly hit R and took all, and oh wow, was that going to be a bad idea? Okay. Apparel. Morokai. Anything gauntlets. Okay. Then. Drop that. And drop those. Okay. There we go. And necklace and ring. All right. Carry weight 58. There's some stuff here that we can't get rid of. That's fine. All right. I forgot to put those back. Ingredients. Sure. Oh. 52. That's better. Is this rabbit leg? Oh, not there, but... There. That is exactly where it should be. Do I think it's going to stay there? No. No, I do not. Alright, so that's it for tonight. I'm gonna kick things over to Juniper Pause's channel. Thank you for joining me, if in fact you did, on this very, very low key event of the crafting catch-up. So this is probably something that I'll do when I don't have a lot of... when I've just got some time to fill in. It seemed like a pretty good deal. I'm going to go back to Solitude, so I am ready to start. Go back to the Blue Palace for this faster. I'm ready to start again tomorrow morning. Yes, I know about the alchemy labs. Thank you. I low-key forgot to go past. Yeah, going the wrong way, aren't I? I low-key forgot to go past that chest and pick up that stuff of Lydia's, or the mine that wasn't there anymore, and steal that gold. Nah, I don't care. The Imperial Army moved in, I just stopped caring. This is the house. Yeah, at the Bard's College. And... save the game. Yeah, I'll save it over the top of the last one. And you know what? I won't. Ah, fuck it, yes. Why not? Alright, and that's it from me. Thank you very much for joining me if you did. If you've been watching YouTube, don't forget to like and subscribe, and you can follow me at CaptainDaff for updates about notifications about when I go live next. Next one will be 7 a.m. tomorrow morning, and we will take on the Bard's College and see how we fare. I'm going to kick things over to Jin Proposer's channel, just playing Remember Me at the moment. Until I see you again next time, drive fast and take chances. Bye.